Good morning and welcome to Berks Heim at Work in Our Community. My name is Ann Gilmer and I'm the Director of Volunteers. With me today is Ann Semmel. Ann Semmel is our Business Development Specialist. Good morning, Ann.
Good morning, Ann.
Thanks for coming along.
Thank you for inviting me again to BCTV. It's always enjoyable to be here.
Yes. Well, okay, Annie, you know that we just had our big, exciting fundraising event, our festival known as Heimfest. And like today's weather, it was a beautiful day. So we were really, really happy to be able to do a lot of things indoors and outdoors.
Right.
So it was very nice. And we thought that we would share some photographs and, you know, little stories about the day. Like I said, it's a very special day. Our residents look forward to it every year. And it's just an amazing day in that 95% of it really is powered and happens all because of our volunteers.
Absolutely.
So it's just awesome. We're just so thrilled to be able to do that.
And I think the beauty of it, too, is there's so many families that are with their loved ones, and it's not just children, it's grandchildren, it's groups of people that the folks that live at Berks Heim really enjoy that time together to, you know, to be able to be connected.
Absolutely.
In ways that they're with the people that they live with there, but then they can also show their families and be supportive of, like, you know, this is my children and grandchildren. It's just an exciting day. And I was really happy to be there and be a part of it this year. It was nice.
Yes, as you said, you and your husband Tom were here this year.
Yeah.
And in fact, you volunteered to pick up and deliver pizza, which is a very popular item on our menu.
Well, it was difficult to give it up because it smelled really good. Victor Emanuel's was so gracious to donate their pizza this year, and it was very well received, and I don't think there was anything left.
it went well, so we were very happy and very appreciative for that, yes. So we'll start by showing some of the slides. And I'm going to start at the beginning. So here are some of our volunteers, and they are also some of our volunteer service board members. And they're at the registration desk where all of the volunteers sign in. And behind them is the queen size quilt, which was raffled later on that day. It was the grand prize in our Heimfest raffle. So, and then we're showing it. People are coming in and they're registering for volunteering. They're also purchasing tickets for the raffle. We had those on sale for the entire day up until the drawing time at 3 o'clock. And then we had name tags for the volunteers. And so it got full, as you can see, as more and more people came. And
the quilt's a big draw. It really is. It was, again, another beautiful piece of work that our quilters do at Berks Heim. And each year they seem to outdo themselves. Each year is a more,
I know,
even more beautiful
more
quilt
beautiful.
Than the year before. But they are beautiful.
Yes. And actually, I do have a picture then to show them actually as they were working on that particular quilt. And then this is some of our other volunteers. Our main hallway is set up with different stands where people can come to get different items. Now again, this is when we were just getting started, so nothing is out yet, but this is where the ice cream would be sold, and these are all volunteers who are going to serve that to our guests and residents. And then here you can see, I think you can figure this out, it's our bake sale. We had tons of wonderful, delicious items, and they were all donated. Church groups, individuals, all the baked goods were donated.
I have to say, we did some sampling of that on Heimfest Day. They were very, very good.
Yes, they always are, yeah.
Wonderful, yeah.
Part of the sale. And these were also volunteers at the bake sale. And then we always look forward to Rufus. Rufus the Clown is a volunteer that comes in every year and entertains there. He's getting an animal together with his balloon for this little boy who's there visiting. And he goes throughout the facility and cheers people and makes the balloons and jokes with them. And so it's just a nice little touch, something to add to the day. And then here is our hot food area that we set up where all of the main menu items are available. You know, the hamburgers and hot dogs and sausage sandwiches, and the pizza was there, and So it's a very busy area, and we have a lot of volunteers that come in to work that, thank goodness. Most of these women here are from farm women groups, and they're a big help at Heimfest and throughout the year. And here we have other folks. As you can see, they're really just getting things set up for the rush to come. So, and here is out in the hallway, and you can see that we have that marked as our hot food area. And folks are lining up to get what they want for their lunch that day. And then another huge and special aspect of Heimfest is all of our musical entertainment. And again, all of these musicians, singers, instrument playing, whatever they're doing, it's all done on a volunteer basis. And here we have the Pretzel City Chorus. And they have been faithful volunteers coming into Heimfest for years now. And I know the residents really enjoy them. And so do the families, of course, as well. So we thank them for coming again this year. And that's always a nice feature
absolutely
of the day.
All the entertainment that they have is always really good and well attended, again, with families
yes.
as well.
Absolutely, yes. Mm-hmm. And then we also have Swing Fever. Swing Fever is a great band, and it's like from the big band mm-hmm. era, the music yeah. that they do. Yeah. And there's some pictures here of different sections. It's a large group, and they always do a fantastic job. You know, they're very skilled, and they really, you
well,
know,
and the music
get the
from
crowd
that
going.
Nobody,
very
nobody
happy.
Yep.
Yes, we've got people on the side dancing to the tunes or tapping their feet and things like that. Here's a shot sort of the full group from the angle, but very popular. And what was really sweet, this year we had a couple that were celebrating their 67th wedding anniversary, mm-hmm. and it just so happened to land on the day of Heimfest, and he and his wife were in the auditorium, both residents, in the auditorium to listen to the music, and she had a beautiful corsage that he got for her, and they played a special song just for them. They played Sentimental Journey, so it was really nice.
Perfect song.
Yes,
yeah.
It was a really nice thing. And then we also had entertainment. Well, this is also in the auditorium. That's right. This is Wendell and his wife, Rita. And they've been coming for years as well, sometimes in different formats, different bands and groups. This year they came as a duo, and they always do a great job. And then later in the day, they go to the Essex Commons unit, and they'll perform down there. And I know the residents there enjoy it very much, enjoy their music. And then on the units, we had folks who would entertain for those who maybe can't get off the unit or choose not to. This is Dave Reinwald and his lovely wife, and they come. They've been here several years as well, and they do a really great job. Beautiful music that they play. We also have the Miller Brothers. They come and entertain throughout the year for Heimfest. Unfortunately, only two of the brothers were available, but they still said, we're going to come in, and they did a great job. They were excellent, very good. And again, we thank them so much as well. And then Bob is a newer volunteer to us. He just started several months ago, and he does a great job. And he's been coming in and playing at unit Christmas party, birthday parties and other special events like that. And he's been very popular. So I asked him if he would be available, and he was very willing. He said, sure, I'd love to come in. So he was also at Heimfest this year and did a great job. Here we have another shot that we're in the day room of one of the units. And then, of course, like Annie was saying earlier, one of the things we love to see, one of the most special things about Heimfest is the families coming in and spending time with their family member who is a resident. And we have folks of all ages that come in, and it's really a special day for everybody, for the residents and the families. And it was such a beautiful day, like I said, so a lot of folks were outside and enjoying the sunshine. It was a little on the cooler side, but it wasn't cold,
no,
you know.
It was
so
nice.
It was gorgeous, yeah. So we're showing some pictures of the families together. Really sweet to see. And there we have a big group there. Mm-hmm. And you can see we also have tents set up. And I do want to mention here these folks are opting for the shade, mm-hmm. and they have tables there with the tents. And I want to thank the Parks Department, the Berks County Parks Department, because they every year they come and they set up these two large tents, one on either side of our main entrance, and then they come back on Monday and they take them down. Now this shot was through the window, so you see the screen, but I just wanted to show you the two tents, how they're spaced out, and it was just a great way for folks to get to enjoy the
outdoors. And it's a welcoming way. When you see the tents, it just kind of gives you that festive feeling as you begin to walk in. And we can't forget that Sammy Steaks was out there with his French fries.
Yes, I've got pictures coming up on that, yes.
They were fabulous, too. The funnel cake, was great.
Yes, very good and very popular. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Another thing, though, that I'll mention first, since that slide is coming up, is our tractor display. And we have to thank Bob Satizan for that. Bob comes most years, weather permitting, of course, and he'll bring several tractors, and sometimes he'll have a friend bring a tractor, too. And it's just a really neat way for folks who either have farming in their background to sort of reminisce about, you know, maybe tractors that they've had, and for others who've never seen a tractor up close, they get to check it out. So it was really nice. It was a great day for that as well. And again, we thank Bob for bringing those in. Mm-hmm. And then here we have Sammy Steaks.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
So Sammy's, we hung out there.
Yeah. Sammy's comes to us, and we're very appreciative for that. And what they serve that day is French fries and funnel cake, like Amy said. Mm-hmm. Two very popular items and foods that the residents don't usually get on their menu, particularly funnel cake. Right. So it's a treat, you know, and it's really nice because they do give, you know, lower prices for our residents, and it's just a nice feature to have. So that's outdoors as well. And here we have another shot. So there's usually always, you know, a crowd there.
I know we waited in line. It was good.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It was worth it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then another thing that we have, which is really a great part of the festival, a great fundraising part of the festival, and that's our flea market. We have items donated from staff, families, even residents sometimes will have a few things in their room that they don't want anymore. And just from, you know, word of mouth, people will bring things in. We have a time period where they can bring the things in. And let me tell you, we got some wonderful things donated this year.
Boy, I did some major shopping in that flea market.
Yeah, there you can see
some things. Yes.
There's some residents there, and there's some staff on their breaks that are there.
Yep.
Yeah, and folks were looking around. And
great
buy. And there again, our volunteers were very busy in that area, helping to find things for people and keep things organized and refill as we needed. And it was quite successful, so we were very happy with that. And then another area that we have is our games section. Mm-hmm. And that's popular. I think originally we set it up for children, grandchildren, really.
Sure.
That would be visiting for something for them to do. But I'll tell you, it's very popular with the residents, too. Very popular. So there's three different games, and there's different prizes. We have the numbers wheel, we have a duck pond, and then we have a ball drop. So they're all, you know, things that children or adults could do. And we have prizes that are given out. Mm-hmm. So that's always a busy area, too. And we give the residents game tickets to play the game, so it doesn't really cost them anything. And then for others, we only charge a quarter, so. But it is a popular area, as you can see. It was full most of the time.
Well, and honestly, for all the residents that live here at Berks Heim, they're given tickets for their food, for everything. Each
That's
person
correct.
Has their name, and the tickets are there and available. And so it's a generous donation. Again,
yes.
Another heartwarming way to give back to the folks that live there. Berks Heim is noted to do that, to the goodwill of the people that live there. And I saw it firsthand this year especially, and it just, it made me feel good as I had to move my mom to Berks Heim this year and having her be a part of it and see that there is so much there to give.
Yes, that's true. And we want to ensure that every resident has the opportunity to enjoy anything that's being offered.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So there's another game shot. And there she has. Now the duck pond is basically you win a prize with every duck, but there's one duck that has a two on it. So then that's the thing. Yes.
You get two prizes.
Two prizes.
Oh, cool.
You do, yes.
I didn't know that. I would have played that.
Yeah. Okay, and then I have some shots now of our raffle, which we do that at 3:00 towards the end of the day. And you can see our administrator, Terry Brennan, is there. He's holding the item that's being raffled off at the moment, along with volunteers in the background, helping to take the items to the winners and so on. And so we started the raffle here. Diane, who's on the left side with the green bucket there, little green bucket, she actually made several cross-stitch pictures and framed, matted and framed them and donated them as part of the raffle. So we had businesses and staff and who donated the prizes for the raffle. And there we are just calling off. This was donated as well. Beautiful fall gift basket with different foods, I believe, that was in that. And here we had, this was done by our quilters. This is a, I think this one is a wall hanging. We had a baby quilt and we had a wall hanging.
Yeah, I think
that's beautiful. Yeah, and so those were, those winners were happy to receive them, absolutely. And we had gift cards. We had gas gift cards. We had food gift cards to restaurants. So it was a nice variety of things. And there you can see the quilt has been moved into the auditorium for the raffle drawing. And then here I did have insert this picture so you could see. This is the quilt that was won this year, but this was earlier in the year, of course, and it's just showing our quilters as they worked on the quilt, as they were actually quilting it. So I thought that would just be nice so you could see when it was made.
Yeah, you know. They do a fabulous job.
They do an excellent job. As a matter of fact, you know, stay posted, maybe, Annie, you can have this on Facebook, but they are going to have another quilt ready. And they're just going to do that as a regular sale.
Oh, nice.
So that's something we can show you when that gets set
up. A
picture
of that to post, that'd be great.
Right. So, of course, I want to thank our staff who worked on that day, EVS, who set everything up and then took everything down, cleaning up as needed, dietary with their help in the preparing of the food items and keeping the food supplied at all the different stands as the day went on. Security, who helped with parking and ran the shuttle for our folks to get to the facility once parking got a little further away. And an extra special thanks to staff who came in and volunteered on their day off. And of course, always a thank you to our wonderful volunteers. And, you know, speaking of wonderful volunteers, I have a few pictures to show you, to share with you that are really special. This here is Helen Latchall. Helen is one of our quilters. She was in the picture showing the quilting. Well, Helen just celebrated her 97th birthday.
Doesn't she look fabulous?
She looks fabulous, absolutely.
You,
she still comes every week and she quilts. And so the quilters are a very tight-knit group, and they do celebrate each other's birthdays. And so for Helen's 97th birthday, they pulled out all the stops and they had a cake for her, which was really cute. It's the icing was done in coconut with a red and yellow to look like flames. And they've got the 97 and they have the fire truck.
Yeah.
So it was really cute.
It
and
really
when you push,
was.
They had batteries in it, so and you push the button and the fire you know, siren would go off.
Yeah.
So it was really cute. Really sweet. And there she is looking at her new toy.
I just think it's awesome. 97 and quilting.
Absolutely.
And so active. It's just fabulous what genetics they have in their family.
Oh, it's fabulous.
Right?
Yeah. And this is Helen with her daughter, Fran. Now, Fran drives Helen there each week, and she also quilts as well. But yeah, our volunteers are amazing, you know, from 97 down to preschoolers who come in at Halloween and parade in their costumes or sing at the holidays. So we are really blessed.
We have that coming up soon, the Halloween trick-or-treat things going on. We're into October now.
Right. So, and then that's the end of our pictures. But Annie, I know you wanted to quick mention a few upcoming community events.
I do, very quickly.
Yes.
This Thursday we're going to be in Kutztown at the fire company. We have an annual health fair. And our state representative, Gary Day, sponsors this every year, and we're always happy to be able to be a part of that.
Yes.
Not to see for the folks for their health fair. And then our big deal is our annual senior expo. And that's going to be held again at the Doubletree on Penn Street. That's on October 24th. And that's going to be from 9 to 3. And that is very, very largely attended. Lots of different vendors, lots of different folks that are going to be there showing their what they do, that whether it's home care, whether right. it's nursing care, lots of giveaways. I know mm-hmm. everybody likes to right. see and to get those things as well. So, yeah, we have a busy October. I can't believe summer's gone.
I know.
And I guess I need to put the flip-flops away and realize it's time. But here we are. We're ready for the next few months and the activities of Thanksgiving and all those good things coming up.
So. Like you said, starting with our fall activities and things that are going on. And then, of course, we're just going to run right into the holidays. And we're planning lots of nice events and parties for our residents. And so we look forward to the holidays as well. It's a very busy time, and the residents are...
I know we've got Toys for Tots that we do that as well, mm-hmm. and that'll be coming up. We just finished a blood drive. Mm-hmm. A Keystone blood drive always comes to our facility, and we have that we had a fairly well-attended group of people that are generous enough to be able to give blood. It's a really important thing now with all the disasters we've had between
Absolutely.
The hurricanes and so many horrific things that we're seeing in the news almost on a daily basis. So, you know, anytime people can give to those things, it's always grateful. And Berks Heim as well has, we did a gathering of things for the people that were affected with the hurricanes.
Yes.
Not too long ago.
We had a good response to that.
We did mm-hmm. that as well. So thoughts and prayers to all those folks and families. You know, we always try to think about not just we here at Berks Heim, but the community in general. I think that is one thing that we're noted for, especially
Absolutely.
Berks Heim. It's a community service, but it's a place where it's history. It's really history for our county.
Absolutely, so. Yes. Mm-hmm. Right, well, thank you, Annie.
Thank you. Yes,
and,
thanks again for having
again,
me.
Again, if you see us at either Kutztown or at...
Berks Encore, the senior expo.
Yep,
our senior expo,
Right, Annie will have lots of information for you. You can answer your questions, and then I'll be there with information about volunteering. So if you're thinking about volunteering or interested in volunteering, I'd be happy to help enlighten you as to what's available at Berks Heim. And so I thank you for joining us, and we won't see you again till the new year.
Oh,
so enjoy your fall and enjoy your holidays.
All right, thank you.